हेलो ऑल, माय नेम इज़ प्रीति कौर, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, जयपुर इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज। इन टुडेज वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस टेक्निकल आर्टिकल्स पार्ट टू। इन अर्लियर वीडियो वी डिस्कस्ड पार्ट वन, देयर वी डिस्कस्ड इंट्रोडक्शन एंड डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ टेक्निकल आर्टिकल्स। नाउ इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ अ टेक्निकल आर्टिकल। सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट। सो While we are structuring a technical article, what should we understand first? So, first thing that we should know is our problem, then approach, and we can say architecture, our methodology, implementation and realization, findings, results and evolution, and recommendation and conclusion, and especially your future scope. The body should contain sufficient motivation with example scenarios, illustrating figures, followed by a crisp genetic problem statement model, for example functionality, particularity, etc. The paper may or may not include formalism, general evaluation of your algorithm or architecture, for example material providing the algorithm, go here, not in the evolution section. Now, what is the requirement? So there are two requirements of effective technical communication. First is subject completeness and second linguistic completeness. Now subject competence is the knowledge of the relevant subject and ability to analyze fact or information for clear presentation. As technical communication is transfer for scientific and technical information and understanding from one person to another person, and it deals with specific and technical subject matter. Now, technical subject matter includes any topic or subject that falls within the general field of science and technology. Now, these are the things. It means architecture, realization, and evolution. Now, summary and future work. So, focus on the main result. Gives you the scope and areas for implementation, directs towards new directions or strengthens the present hypothesis. Now, acknowledgement, your bibliography, your appendix. In appendix, you can mention detailed protocol descriptions, proofs with more or two lines, and other low level but important details. So, while we are writing an article, what would be our procedure? So the thing is that write the problem section first, then write the approach, result and recommendation sections. The conclusions comes next. Write the introduction last, since it closes the conclusion in one of the last paragraphs. Finally, write the abstract, and lastly, give your paper a title. So let's talk about experimental paper. What should you do? So papers that introduce a new learning setting or types of application. Papers describing a new algorithm should be clear, precise, comparable, and performance measurable. Another useful way of describing an algorithm is to define the space of hypothesis that it searches when optimizing the performance measure. Now, the papers including a new algorithm should conduct experiment comparing to the state of the art algorithms for the same or similar problems. Unusual performance criteria should be carefully defined and justified. All experiment must include measures of uncertainty of the conclusions. These typically take a form of confidence intervals, statistical tests, and estimates of standard error. Proper experiment methodology should be employed. And description of the software and data sufficient to replicate the experiment must be included in the paper. Conclusion drawn from a series of the experiments run should be clearly stated. Graphical display of experimental data can be very effective. Supporting tables of extract numerical results from experiment should be provided in an article appendix. And limitation of the algorithm should be described in details. So let's have conference review process for technical articles or technical papers. So it is hard to generalize the review process of conferences, but operate according to these basic rules. So these are the basic rules. The first one is the paper is submitted to the technical program chair, mostly in postscript of PDF format. Second, the technical program chair assigns the paper to one or more technical program committee members, also called expert committee. Any good conference will strive to provide at least 3 reviews. However, since conferences operate right under deadline and not all reviewers deliver as promised. Third thing is, the technical program chair then collects the reviews and sorts the paper according to the average review scores. So, the TPC, rather than the subset that can make the meeting, and then meets the person or by the phone or conference. Then the paper is selected to present it in the conference. Now keep in mind that the identity of this TPC member is kept secret. Now let's talk about graphical presentation of information. So graphic aids help to simplify complex information. Graphics lend visual impact and condense large number of information into a small space. One picture is worth 1,000 words. Should choose the correct graphics depending on the nature of data like graphs, chart, etc. Represented in logical way and should supplement information. Now let's talk about types of article. So here we have scientific article, technical article and research paper. What is scientific article? Theoretical in the treatment of the subject. It is an attempt to bring out the research from the laboratory to the world. And the language may be technical, but has to be made understood in simple words. Now let's see what is technical article. It is less theoretical in the subject, concentrate in the practical aspect of those subject. It relates the ideas of resulted from research that can be used to improve the life and the society. So these are the main points of your scientific article and general literary articles. Now let's talk about general guidelines that we should always keep in our mind when we are going to write any article. So first thing is that define the audience and purposes. Create the work plan to write the article. Collect and evaluate necessary data. Examine the latest research on the topic. Prepare research notes. Prepare a list of references and bibliography, develop an outline, write a rough draft, and revise the document. In this way, we can make an effective article. Thank you.